It is digital and it works in the UHF spectrum. It combines the best of two worlds. It features an automatic setup and offers great sound. It is lightweight and it is extremely rugged.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Evolution Wireless Digital.
EWD is Sennheiser's next step in the evolutionary chain. It is digital when it comes to picking up the sound and operating the system, but it is RF when it comes to reliably transmitting its audio signal in the UHF band. Besides that, it offers too many new features to say this is the younger brother of the Evolution G4 series. So let's consider it as a completely new digital wireless device with its own design to meet modern day's challenges.
All right. The smell of new technology. Ah, I love it. And if you open the box, you'll find everything you need to wirelessly capture great audio for your live music, your presentations, and your lectures.
The box comes with a half-rack receiver and a body pack or a handheld transmitter. The standard AA batteries the box also comes with will offer about 8 hours of operation time.
Yeah, about the batteries, you could get yourself lithium-ion battery packs and chargers as an accessory. Not only do you get rid of dead batteries or half-dead batteries you don't know what to do with, but also you'll crank up your operation time to 12 hours.
That is what the manual says, 12 hours. And to test that, we brought in a crash test dummy. We named it Frankie, and we did a very boring test with him. Boring, but interesting.
Exactly.
We set up two identical EWD handheld microphones, one with AA batteries, the other with a lithium-ion battery pack. Then we had Frankie introduce himself over and over again, for a long, long time.
Hello, my name is Frankie.
We clocked 8 hours and 32 minutes before the signal started to go weak.
My name is Frankie.
With standard AA batteries, that is. For the lithium iron battery pack, we clocked 13 hours and 16 minutes.
Hello, my name is Frankie.
The operation time may vary a little bit depending on the range and the congestion you put your EWD set through. But this test is a good reference.
Also in the box, rack mount angles, power supply adapters, and you'll find antennas. As a standard, you'll find quarter wave dipole antennas. Though if you want more range, as an accessory, Sennheiser offers halfway dipoles. Or you could get external antennas. To give you an idea what the range is between transmitter and receiver with the antennas the box comes with, we activated Frankie's lavalier mic and we tried to push it to the limit.
Hello, hello, testing, testing.
In an ideal condition, the system offers up to 100 meters.
Hello, hello.
That's about 330 feet.
Hello, hello, testing, testing.
Absorption, attenuation and congestion are its main challenges.
Testing, testing.
We covered 80 meters.
Hello, hello, testing, testing.
260 feet.
Well, yeah, that's how far it goes.
But even if we go down to a bare minimum of, let's say, a single digit meter distance, that's still 30 feet between transmitter and receiver. On most stages, that should suffice.
Yeah, should be enough. Okay, last but not least, in your box, you'll find something that you actually already own. Because if you want, you can operate the system with your smartphone or your tablet.
With the box also comes free access to the Smart Assist app. If you install it on your smartphone or tablet, you can configure, control, and operate your EWD system from wherever you want within range.
Yep. Using the Smart Assist app, you literally have all the power to operate the system within the palm of your hand.
You can name your channel, give it a color to keep the system organized. You can enjoy an automated setup procedure with an auto scan. and there is a manual frequency manager in case you prefer not to use the automated one. Also, there's a mute switch on the receiver side.
This button right here can overrule the mute switch on the microphone. Very cool.
Gain control, range indicators, battery life indicators, it's all there.
Okay, and just in case you get stuck, which is very unlikely to happen because EWD is extremely simple to use, but just in case, in your app, you could go to the support hub.
In the support hub, you can find extra information on all the parts and procedures. You can find films, manuals, quick tips and tricks to get the best out of your EWD system.
Smart Assist app. It's pretty handy, right?
Keep in mind, if, for whatever reason, you cannot use your smartphone or tablet, you lost it or you forgot to charge it, don't worry. You can perfectly operate the system by using the buttons and menus on the receiver.
Okay. Now, if you would like to use more than one microphone at the same time, EWD offers up to 90 channels that can work alongside of each other. 90 channels. It depends a bit on the environment you use it in, but 90 channels, that's probably way more than you actually need. But the reason for that is the equidistant tuning grid.
To explain this, let's first have a look at how a system behaves that is non-equidistant. Such a system produces intermodulation, which is not necessarily a problem if you place calculated frequencies unevenly every few hundred kilohertz. If you don't do that, this intermodulation could cause interference and dropouts. Now, while uneven spacing is effective for avoiding intermodulation, it drastically limits the number of wireless microphones that can be used in a dedicated space. The equidistant tuning grid, on the other hand, is an algorithm a wireless microphone system can use to place wireless channels in an equally spaced grid. For EWD, this spacing is 600 kHz, which means that, within the given bandwidth, one can place a wireless channel every 600 kHz.
If you organize the channels in such a way that they're closer together without suffering from intermodulation, well, more channels can be allocated. In this case, up to 90.
That being said, EWD comes in several sets. You could choose a lavalier set, a handheld set, combo set, head mic set, instrument set, and a bass set. They all come with half-rack receivers, but where the lavalier, the head mic, and the instrument set come with a body pack transmitter, the handheld set comes with a handheld transmitter with a mute switch and a MMD-835 capsule. For the lavalier set, we have two options. Option 1, the set comes with an ME2 microphone, which is an omnidirectional lavalier microphone. Or you could go for a lavalier set that comes with an ME4. A cardioid lavalier microphone. The combo set is the exact same as a lavalier set, but it adds the capsule and the handheld transmitter of a handheld set. Note that the combo set is only available with the ME2. The head mic set, on the other hand, comes with an ME3 head mic, rather than a handheld or a lavalier microphone. The instrument set comes with a CI1 cable. That's a cable to hook up an instrument with a quarter-inch jack. And finally, EWD comes in two bass sets. Either a receiver with a body pack without a lav mic, nor a CI1 cable, nor a headset mic. Or you could get a receiver with a handheld transmitter without a capsule. Additionally, you can buy components and capsules individually. Or you could get several accessories like the lithium-ion battery pack, the collar caps, the external antennas, etc. Check out Sennheiser's website to find what you're looking for.
Okay, now, since we have Frankie, our crash test dummy, and since the manual says EWD is extremely robust, we thought, let's come up with some sort of stage dive test that slightly goes wrong. You never know. And I know in some countries it's forbidden to stage dive, but this is purely for the sake of science and technology.
If you want to know more about how to use EWD in a live music, a business or educational environment, check out the following episodes on EWD. Evolution Wireless Digital, evolving with you.
Hello, hello, testing, testing. Hello, hello, testing, testing. Well, Frankie lost his head and an arm, but EWD is still going strong. Let's go, Frankie. Let's go fix your head.